Hey, I'm Scott Hansman, and it is Azure Friday. I'm here with Mark Sims, and we're talking about queues. Mm-hmm. We've taken a naive queue, and we've made it async. We've added batching. We've made it smarter. We've got background tasks now. Mm-hmm. But I pull 32 messages off of the queue, and I fan out, mm-hmm. and one of them stays forever.
Mm-hmm. Or is that worse, starts throwing exceptions every single time.
Okay, that's bad.
Yeah, and what's even worse is bad actors in a system will start to predominate. It's like being at the grocery store. You know that one person in front of you starts paying in pennies? Or pulls out a checkbook, mm-hmm. and all of a sudden two people show up, and then the next thing, all those lines are full. Mm. This is what bad messages will do in any form of queuing system. They'll start to predominate. So you got to identify it, and you got to get them out of the pool.
So you're saying that literally, like, it will find a status quo where everyone's bad, no good person can get their work done.
I've seen that happen in less than 30 seconds on major production systems.
Really?
If you don't implement poison message handling.
Poison message handling.
So let's just start by assuming that a poison message, we'll take a very simple approach first, that a poison message is one that I can't process, that it blew up an exception.
Okay.
And remember, in a queue, if I grab it and then I don't delete it, it's going to show back up in a short period of time.
Okay.
And it becomes visible again. But there's a really
good... Because someone else is going to grab it.
Exactly.
It never got done.
Especially if I had a dozen different instances all pulling off the network.
Okay.
So one of the really neat things you can do is I can start off by going, hey, is this a valid message or not? So I can look at the message DQ count and know how many times I've been pulled out.
Ah, that's what that means.
Yeah.
How many times have we tried to help you? Now, you're no longer welcome here.
So let's just say that, hey, if I've been pulled out more than 3 times...
Without being deleted.
I cannot be processed.
You've been banned from coming to friendlies.
Out of the pool. So, let's go and let's get rid of that.
Okay.
Let's put this somewhere else.
I see. So you can delete it, which would just be give up. But you could also put it into a mm-hmm. a preferred customer pile.
And you absolutely want to do that for the simple reason that what if it's just a perfectly valid message but your code doesn't know how to process yet.
Mm.
Or what if you've exposed an interface to other people, and they just sent you something that you had a bug, or you want to be able to have these things. You want to go back and look at them later.
Dead letters.
Exactly. This is a manual implementation of a dead letter queue, but we're providing the logic of what a dead letter is.
Mm.
So we could do a couple things. We could go and we could drop this back into a different queue.
Okay.
But that's a problem because queues are by their very nature semi-durable.
Right, we only have 7 days.
We only have 7 days. And I might only want to go back like once a week or once a month, or I might want to have these things around for a long time. But we have Azure storage and we have these great things called tables.
I see. You're gonna upgrade this to manual processing.
Probably. Yep. I'm gonna take the thing I don't know how to deal with and I'm gonna put it in a table.
Gotcha.
Basically, my dead letter table.
And then an administrator later on will come and deal with that.
Well, if you have a batch job, probably like using the Azure scheduler or something manual like Quartz, to go through and go, okay, what kind of messages do we not know how to process?
Mm-hmm.
In production, hopefully this will be a very small number, but
right.
during dev and test, this is critically important. Because otherwise, you don't know what you can't process.
So if I were building a larger company and a big kind of dashboard, and I've got mm-hmm. some great touch dashboard, I would probably want to use the APIs to go and watch my health and mm-hmm. The system and say, oh, look, there's 10,000 things in the queue and there's like 100.
Yeah.
That's a big percentage differentiation.
Yeah.
What's going
on? Or
even
just one or two, because those could be your most critical ones.
That's a valid point as well.
Yeah. So let's just go and let's just add a table now. Table client is storage account. The nice thing about putting it in tables is you've already done all the work.
Gotcha. And then you go, I assume, get table reference at this
yeah.
point then. And
strangely
make a dead
enough,
letter one. Bad work. Nice.
And again, I'm going to put in my table, create if not exists. Just because I don't
which would go back up there, makes sense.
Yeah, but just do it once.
Got it.
And it's not that I have to do it once and only once globally. It's just as long as I'm not going and trying to create every time I want to do
it. In a loop. Got it.
So then I'm just going to go, and I'm going to create some, yep. So let's just go and look at our table. So I want to create a new table operation.
You're creating a table operation.
Yes, because I want to basically put something into a table. So I want a table operation.insert, and I want to put something in.
I see.
And I'm not going to bother creating any sort of type for this. I'm just going to use a dynamic table entity.
And that's kind of an envelope, like we have that that queue envelope?
Yep, and it basically takes a partition key, a row key, a tag, and then just a list of properties.
That seems more complicated than a message. Before, with messages, we just wrapped it up and threw it in.
But tables are structured and queues aren't.
I see.
Yep. Or actually, no. Let's avoid dynamic table entities. Let's just use the API the way it was meant to be used.
So what did we just abandon here?
We're not going to use dynamic table entities. We're actually going to go and create.
Making a proper envelope, yeah. a formal envelope of yeah. for the whole. So a bad person will have people.
Yes.
Would it not just have a person?
Table entities can't be nested. They can only contain basic types.
I see.
Because it's just a flat list of basic parameters.
Okay. Strings, so you're going to have to map these two things together then.
Yeah. So we've got that. And I'm going to have to provide a partition key and a row key.
Okay. What does that mean?
Basically, how do I tables are key value lookup. So I need to know which chunk of things that the data is in, and I need to have some uniquely identifying row key.
Okay.
But we're going to cheat.
Is that good?
Yes, because okay. this table is not going to be huge.
A couple thousand, maybe at most,
If we have more than that, we have other problems.
Yeah.
I just want something where I can just put data in and it'll hang around for a while.
Right.
So bad person is going to be a new bad person. And let's just go and set up the partition key. Let's just make today's date.
I see. So that each day there'd be a different partition.
Yep.
Gotcha.
Date time dot now.
UTC now.
Yep. UTC now as well.
Sorry. I've long time. I've had myself hurt very badly with the.
Actually, do you know the performance reason to use UTC now?
I can tell you the. You tell me that first. Yeah.
So datetime.now is actually datetime.utcnow with a time zone wrapper around it.
I see.
It's actually significantly slower.
The problem that I have had with UTCnow is it runs at 1:59 and then it runs at 2:01 and it goes back in time.
Yeah.
And then things will hop around. I have a long running bug where my blog, this is a little secret here, my blog is down for 1 hour every year because I have a UTC bug that I never fixed. It goes back in time. And when people tweet me once a year, hey, your blog's down, just wait an hour. It'll come back.
It'll be fine. All right, so row key, we can just do a GUID. It's fine.
Okay.
I'm just going to scan through.
Sure, yeah. If there were some other unique thing we could use as well.
Exactly. So then just guess what? Actually, we don't want to do a structured because we may not have been able to deserialize this message properly. So
you kind of want to just stick in a string, wouldn't you?
Yeah, exactly.
Because you don't know what's wrong. Maybe it was a deserialization problem.
Yeah, it should just be thing.
And you got choices here.
Yeah, it's called content.
Yeah.
That'd be a little bit more.
Yeah, you get choices though.
Yeah.
So you don't know why it's wrong. Could have been bad serialization, could be any number.
Could
of
be
anything. And there might be additional context you want to add along as well.
Exactly. So I'm just going to say as string. Yep, there we go.
Because the deserialization could have failed.
Exactly. I just want to get that raw value. And then we have a table operation to insert this row.
Okay.
And then the table. Execute.
I see. So table operation is a pending message. It's a verb that you haven't actually done, and then execute says do this thing.
Here's a set of things to change. And just like queues let me batch, tables let me batch as well.
Ah.
So I could create a set of operations. In this case, I just need one.
And are they atomic?
Yes. Within a single partition.
Within a single partition.
Yeah. So if I was updating today, I could atomically update today.
I see.
And because we're good neighbors, we don't want to hog the CPU when we don't need it.
So you know what would be cool? It might be too much for one. You try this. Could we put a breakpoint in here, and right before we go and grab the message, let's make it bad.
Yep.
You know what I mean? Or maybe actually we could probably we could post something foul and cause this to happen.
Yep. Well, basically what we can do is let's do something. Let's have some fun here. If mesgq count is less than 3, throw new application exception.
So you're going to force fails.
Yes. I'm going to force it to fail a bunch of times until the DQ count goes up.
Okay.
Now, granted, I now need to take my try-catch.
Yeah, you could have this fail in any number of ways, but that's a good way. Okay.
Yeah, but if I don't put my, this is where I need to make sure my error handling is correct, because if I don't put a try-catch around this, it's going to blow up. Actually, I don't even need to throw an application exception. I can just basically say, do nothing.
Yeah, a return at that point, yeah.
Yeah, the only other thing we would want to make sure is we need to change the visibility time. Otherwise, we'll be sitting around a very long time waiting for this.
What is visibility time?
How long this message is invisible before it can be seen by somebody else.
Oh, can you just make it a second or two? Or?
Yep, so we're just going to say visibility timeout, time span from seconds one.
I see. So you might, depending on how important it is, if it's an order or any number, you could say, hey, give it 5 minutes.
Yep.
Backend processor will come back up
yep.
or
so
whatever.
So message count is set, visibility timeout. So the problem is, once we give it one, we
and
need to give
it. And then it wants all of the options.
Yep.
And yeah, you're trying to be clever, assuming that that yeah. Will allow you to do named parameters, but it looks yep. like that operation.
Oh no, it's fine. I just need to give it all of them, because they weren't optional parameters.
That's a shame.
There we go.
Okay, cool. Yep.
All right, so then we can come in and we can basically say, we'll just run this.
Cool.
And we'll throw a message in, and then we'll see it dequeuing a couple of times. And I probably made a mistake in here. It'll probably blow up at some point, but that's okay.
No, this is good.
Yep.
I personally find I learn more when I make a mistake and mm-hmm. I find it, and when I watch videos and someone makes a mistake. I'm even starting to put mistakes in my demos on purpose, and then I'm starting to make the audience wonder whether or not I caused the mistake.
Well, the positive path is always easy.
Well, it's no fun, I think, and this is one of the reasons that I like doing this and why I like putting together these shows, is that everybody sees the tech ed demo that was perfect.
They didn't see these 600 tries beforehand.
Right.
Where just yeah. normal stuff you run into.
You know, sticking the landing is great for, you know, the Olympics. But the reality is, you know, they've seen that flow chart of what programming is like. It's like, arg, yeah. arg, ah.
And most of the time, you're not working on the stuff that just magically happened. It's the,
it never worked.
Something broke. I need to be able to understand why and how.
Right. Well, so, and then you're making all this up as you go along, which is exactly what I like to see. Nope, you're still posting off to RunScope.
Oh, there we go. Still had our breakpoint set here.
Okay.
And it's still loading up. So I'm just in a second, Will. What I should have done is actually gone and posted the message directly.
Directly into the worker role?
Yeah, directly into the queue.
That's a good point.
Yep. But
you have an indirect post here.
Yeah, so we're going through. Yep, we got our message.
So here's your web role that's grabbed the message, and you can just let that
Yep, we just let that one ride. Come into our Server Explorer. Now we're in our DQ count.
So DQ count 1.
Yep, because we pulled it out once. So we come in here, and we just look at what's in the queue.
There he is.
Yep, DQ count is 1.
There's that. Got it.
Yep, so now we just F5 it again. DQ count 2.
Yep. So he's failing.
DQ count 3, because this is coming through really fast, and because I'm breakpointing, it takes some time.
Now, what's going to happen when it's neither 3, you know? See, it's not, that's not going to...
It's going to skip it.
We have a middle place there where it's neither.
I had an off by 1 issue,
and then
it's just in limbo.
Yeah, so it's going to sit there forever.
Yep, so let's just go.
Because no one's ever going to pull it off.
So let's just go in and DQ that message.
Okay.
Oh.
Who grabbed it?
No, actually, I think that must have gone through, because it actually... Oh no, because it's continuously grabbing it.
Yeah.
It's always looping through.
So you're only catching moments when it's not there for
Yeah.
So just make one of those a greater than or equal to.
Yeah. I love the
There's people watching that are like, I knew that.
You did something wrong. We just did that. We put that in there deliberately.
Of course.
So that people would feel good about the world.
Clearly.
Yeah. So let's
see if we can wrap it up and stick the landing like the Olympics.
Yeah. There we go. Here's our pommel horse moment. Let's just make sure that there's
too soon?
Nothing in the queue. Okay, good. Run through again. For stuff like this, I just like using the emulator. It's nice and quick. You've got full kind of debuggability.
Well, I'm impressed. It's a tiny little laptop you've got here, too.
Yeah. Physically and computationally.
Yeah.
One of the other things I'll do is I'll just stand up a VM image in Azure, drop a trial of Visual Studio on, because that way you're co-located with the real storage account, and your latency is much more indicative.
That's an interesting idea too. I never thought about that. That's a good tip.
Because this is just the debug. This is just the storage emulator. It's not going to give me. If I want to see, like, I want to pull, you know, 1,000.
But rather than having, you have to bring the storage all the way down. You're sitting there in the same, in the same place.
You're going to get the same behavior that your application would in the cloud.
All right. So we're posting people.
Yeah, we're posting. We're posting. We're still loading. Cue Jeopardy music.
And of course, you could pull these this queue onto another monitor if you wanted to.
Oh, absolutely.
Okay.
All right. There we go. DQ count.
So one. We can just turn him off then.
Yep. DQ count greater than or equal to 3. All right. Okay. So we generate our bad person.
Three failures, and now we throw it into the table.
And there's our bad person.
Got it. And there's the content.
Partition key.
Additional
row key.
Yep. So we throw that bad guy into the table, and then can we look at table? And
absolutely can. So now we come in here to our tables. Bad work. There we go.
Okay, so then we've moved that bad actor from the queue, which lives for 7 days, and now here, which potentially lives forever.
Lives forever.
And we can deal with it.
There you go. Poison message handling.
Poison message handling. It's Azure Friday.